Good morning.
Good morning, please sit down. Mr. Arpit.
Yes, sir.
From Rajasthan. Why do you wish to join civil service?
Sir, I think, sir, civil service asset provides a very good job in government service. And from this service, we can impact a lot of people directly.
And you also want a good career. This will give you a great career. Alright, so what qualities do you possess which will make you a good civil servant?
Sir, I'm committed to what I'm working. I'm honest for my work. And I think I gain knowledge.
Not too late. Is this your first attempt?
It's my third attempt, but third first.
Yeah. You look very young. How
yes,
old are you?
I'm 25 years.
25. That's also very young. By mostly people are coming after 28, 29. Yes.
Mr. Arpit, you given foreign service as your second option. Okay, now, you know, sometime back, there was this tussle going on between the US authorities and the Chinese firm called Huawei.
Yes.
Are you aware of that?
Yes, sir.
And on the directions of the US, they had detained the CFO of the organization in Canada.
Yes.
So, why? What is the issue?
Actually, if you see in the larger scenario, this is the part where US and China are having a kind of trade war. And the US authorities were having an allegation that Huawei was using their data, data breach and some security concerns were there. I'm not aware of the exact allegations that were made. But these were...
They made two specific allegations. They said that A, Huawei was indulging in spying on behalf of the Chinese government.
Yes.
And secondly, that their companies had violated the sanctions in Iran. And that is why they have got this very detained in Canada. Right? Has China taken any retaliatory action against Canada after the detention of this lady? Any idea?
Second.
Now, in Assam, the NRC is being updated. Are you aware of that?
Yes.
What is the NRC?
So, National Register for Citizens. It is a list of citizens that is specifically, it has been designed for Assam and for the peoples who had migrated after 1971. This list has been there so that illegal migrants can be identified.
Okay. Basically, to identify who are the bona fide residents and who are the illegal migrants, right?
Yes.
And the cutoff date is 71. Now, we had this citizenship amendment bill, which of course has lapsed now. Now, why did it generate so much of resentment in the Northeast and also in Assam?
This citizenship bill has taken the date forward to 2014.
Yeah,
and some of the communities are given status of Indian citizen as per that. The citizenship bill has reduced the criteria from 12 years to 6 years for some communities.
Yeah, yes, sir. Basically, the issue is that from 71, the cutoff date was taken up to 2014, December 2014, right? Now, have you heard of this Financial Action Task Force?
Yes.
What is that?
Sir, it's an international organization, you can say, where of the EU, of European Union. India is also part of it. And it takes care of the money laundering aspects and black money generation in the...
Terror financing. Primarily, terror financing. Money laundering and terror financing. That is the basic thrust of it. Now, they concluded the meeting yesterday in Paris. What decision was taken on Pakistan?
I'm not aware of yesterday meeting, but recently Pakistan was included in the grey list.
Last year. It was That's right. It was included in the grey list last year. We had tried to get them listed as blacklisted, but they have decided to extend the grey list for a few months, I think up to June this year, when they will review it again. What happens if they are put on the blacklist?
Okay.
Now, have you heard of this term called extradition?
Yes.
What is extradition?
Sir, extradition is taking some individuals out of the country. Like, if I can explain by example, we have recently extradited Michael.
Christian Michel.
Christian Michel.
Correct.
From UAE.
Correct.
And we are also in the process of extradicting Indian citizen NRI Vijay Mallya from UK.
Right.
And there are other people.
That's right. Now, why did we extradite Christian Michel from UAE?
Sir, it is alleged that he was involved in the scam related to Augusta
Westland. Okay. Thank you.
Arpit, you are from Chittorgarh, Rajasthan, right? Why is Chittorgarh famous?
Sir, Chittorgarh is famous for its historical reasons. It has a great fort. It is also included in the UNESCO World Heritage Sites. And historical figures like Rana Pratap, Rana Kumbha, Mirabai and Padmini.
Okay. Now, what would you say are the main takeaways from the recent visit of Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman of Saudi Arabia? Main takeaways?
Sir, the Crown Prince of Saudi Arabia has signed pacts of investment of around $100 billion, has promised to for that, and India and Saudi Arabia has issued a joint statement regarding terrorism, and we are also conducting some naval exercise with Saudi Arabia. These are the points.
You mentioned about 100 billion. Has he really committed, or he just made a statement that there are possibilities of investment in India to the tune of? Which one is correct?
Sir, there is possibility that statement I can...
Okay, you left out some important points, so read up on this. He agreed to invest in, we have an infrastructure and investment fund.
Yes.
Sovereign fund of the government of India. So he expressed his willingness to invest in that. And then there were few MOUs signed on terrorism, sharing of intelligence, on tourism, etc., etc. What is Train 18?
Sir, Train 18 or Gatiman Vande Mataram Express. It is one of the fastest trains in India, going from Agra to Varanasi.
Vande Mataram Express, or?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
It is being recently in the rank.
Give us some details about the who has manufactured it, whether it's been imported or is it. Give us some details.
Sir, my knowledge, it's manufactured indigenously.
Yes,
but
correct.
I'm not aware of the company or PSU that has made it.
Which is the main PSU in India which manufactures railway wagons, coaches? Integral Coach Factory. Okay. And what else you know about it?
Sir, if I talk about the facilities, some good facilities. I'm not aware of the details as such.
Okay, never mind. But read up on this. There is an article by Raghu Dayal in the Times of India editorial page yesterday. Complete article is there on the train. what is the investment, what are the facilities offered, what is the timeline that has been taken, etc., etc. Now, from your hobby, I find that you have played badminton at the university level, right?
Yes.
Now, a major badminton event is coming up next month. It's called the Blue Ribbon of Badminton in the world.
It's All England Open Badminton.
All England Badminton Championships. Okay. Who are the Indians who are going to participate?
The top players, I think, sir.
Men.
Men.
Start with men.
Kidambi Srikanth would be fit, I think.
Yes.
H.S. Pranay, Sai Praneet. Saurabh Verma has.
No. Verma is next to Srikanth. Samir Verma is number two. So he's already in. And Pranay, of course, is in. The rest will have to qualify. And among the women?
Saina Nehwal, P.V. Sindhu.
Yeah, that's it. Thank you.
Jogging is your interest?
Yes.
So what body changes take place when you jog?
Ma'am, jogging involves exercise of lower body and it also pumps the heart. So
do some hormones take place? Is there a change?
No, sir. As I'm not aware.
Serotonin. It gives you a feeling of well-being. Alright. You also won an award in geospatial survey competition. So what work did you do here?
Ma'am, geospatial survey is use of GPS receiver and it uses the GPS technology of satellites. So we had to plot the whole university in the minimum time. It was a competition. So we were allotted some initial coordinates and then we had to map the whole city.
Through spatial photography, can you find out something about natural resources?
Yes, ma'am. If we take the remote sensing photographs, there are different colors for different things. Like if it is vegetation, it would be having a different monochromatic colors. If it is some natural resource, is like mines or minerals, there are different colors for that.
So do we have any remote sensing institute in India?
Yes, ma'am.
Where and what's it called?
It's in Dehradun, and Indian Remote Sensing Institute.
Now, you are also from Rajasthan and you mentioned something about tourism. So what is the tourist potential of Rajasthan?
Ma'am, currently we have around 4.5 to 6 million of people of footfall annually. And tourism accounts for around 10% of GDP of Rajasthan. And we are still lagging behind in our potential, and we have targeted in Rajasthan that we should have this around 8 to 10 million of people footfall, and currently we are having around 6% of the foreign tourist footfall, and this we are targeting around.
So what are the main tourist areas in Rajasthan?
Ma'am, in my opinion, Jaipur, Jodhpur, Udaipur, Ajmer, Chittor is also one of the good tourist, and Jaisalmer, desert safari is there.
What about all these melas like Pushkar?
Yes, ma'am. They are also cultural festivals.
Yes. Okay, fine. Now you've also taken up anthropology.
Yes.
So we hear concepts like urbanization, modernization, westernization. Do you think our social institutions are changing because of these three factors? Like the institution, let's say, of marriage. Is there a change?
Ma'am, if we analyze it in a whole picture, the institution of marriage has been undergoing change from past few centuries, but it has taken a speed after this our independence, because we have taken a path of modernization. And if we say this particular institution, marriage, earlier there were more joint families,
mm-hmm.
and now it has become nuclear families are more. And recently, Supreme Court has also allowed live-in relationship to adopt a baby. So there is
not necessarily to adopt a baby. Live-in relationship is far legal now. Okay. Anything else? Since you are talking about marriage, what about inter-caste marriages?
Yes. Earlier there was rigidity regarding the exogamy and endogamous marriages, but now as such in the modernization, people have this rigidity has been somewhat relaxed due to the education and modern.
Also because of urbanization, people move to urban cities and nobody really asks about caste.
Yes.
Okay, another concept, migrations. What are the effects of migrations?
on the part of person who is migrating, he faces an unknown environment totally.
Yes.
So he is not welcome generally in the place where he wants to migrate, and he faces some social discrimination. And if we say that some government benefits that are also accrued to the poor people or people who are really in need cannot be availed.
What about those people who are left behind, like family members?
If we see in the positive side, migration also brings up the employment. The family that have been left behind, women particularly and children, women take up the jobs in daily
agriculture. Okay, thank you.
What is meant by particularly vulnerable travel groups?
Particularly vulnerable tribal groups are those tribal groups, generally they are not included in scheduled tribes, but they may be, and if they are having special needs.
How to define?
Definition as such is according to their occupation, like we have no fixed criteria for defining that, but we have taken criteria like most primitive mode of economy, social backwardness, shyness of contact, and
how many such groups are there?
75.
Most 75. Earlier, what they were known by some other name? PTGs.
PTGs. Yes, sir.
And total population.
Particularly
many
of that. Yeah. Sir, I'm not
aware of it. 32.4 lakhs. Okay. Now, Constitution has provided certain guarantees, certain safeguards for the civil rights. Can you mention a few important provisions?
Sir, starting from the right to equality, we have provisions in Article 15 and 16 for employment and education. There is Article 46 in DPSP. Which says that
certain specific provisions for these sections,
strict schedule and strict schedule areas, in Article 44, where we have marked certain areas that would be administered by tribal groups according to their needs.
National Commission for Civil Tribes.
Yes, sir. Which article is it? It's Article 339 and 339.
Okay, now, and there was an act very recently. If you were well connected, which protects the interests of the civil tribes. What is that?
It was forest rights.
Now the implementation of the FRA has come in for a lot of introspection, and Honorable Supreme Court has also given certain directions on that. Are you aware of that?
Sir, recently there has been some controversy regarding the eviction of tribal peoples and other forest dwelling communities from states. It's around 2.3 million people who would be affected. It is regarding the claims settlement.
What kind of direction is given by the
Supreme Court? Supreme Court acting on the FRA, there were claims to be settled, like people had to give why they should be allowed to stay in the forest. Some certain provisions were there, like 3 years of settling and 75 years.
Okay, now another question. Energy sector, what are the initiatives taken by the in Rajasthan to promote the interest of the energy sector?
Sir, in Rajasthan, there is a huge potential for renewable energy, and we have in accordance with the National Solar Mission, we have installed capacity of around 18 gigawatts, and we are able to extract around 4 gigawatts of electricity from that.
In the petroleum sector, any initiatives?
Yes, sir. Recently, in past few years, Pachpadra refinery in Barmer has been functional, and new explorations have been going on in Barmer.
Last question. Venezuela, what is happening there?
The Venezuelan crisis is regarding this political crisis that has happened. So due to the very high inflation rates and the balance of payment crisis that had occurred a few years back. And
how is India concerned with that?
Sir, India has is an oil importer country, and Venezuela is the second
highest oil we import. How much of oil we import from Venezuela? What percentage?
Rajasthan has some very serious social problems.
Yes.
Can you identify those?
Sir, the literacy rate in Rajasthan is very low, 66%, as compared to the national average of 74%. Particularly the female literacy rate, which is 52%. And there is issue of child marriage. It is around 35% in Rajasthan. It is very high as compared to national average. And the issue of child marriage, recently it has been dropped that Bhilwara district in Rajasthan is having the second highest number of child marriages. And similarly, sir, the issue, all the health indicators of Rajasthan
also very poor.
Are there. Mm-hmm.
Like IMR, MMR.
Yes.
What is the reason? Poverty?
Sir, poverty is one reason. Other is, sir, I think, sir, it's educational awareness, and the inability, I think, sir, on the part of people.
Two reasons, basically. One is poverty. Poverty is a very degrading factor in life. Second is the force of customs.
Customs, yes, sir.
There is some prejudice against girls, you know, women that considered a burden. Now, Rajasthan has made some good progress in certain areas. Can you identify those progress areas?
Sir, if we take the recent steps, the child sex ratio has improved in last 3 years.
How much is it now?
It's around 990 from 888. It has risen.
It has improved so much?
Yes.
All over the country or only in some pockets?
It's in Rajasthan.
Rajasthan?
Yes, sir.
How much it is?
It's 919.
990 is very good.
919
is very good. What is the national average?
6918 according to 2011 census.
926, I think we check. Okay. So that is one area. What else? Sex ratio has improved.
Sex ratio. Sir, Rajasthan has introduced a Bhamashah Yojana, where it is a women empowerment scheme where financial independence will be.
Bhamashah, very good. Tell more. Anything else? Briefly, just go on telling the schemes or improvements. Labour reforms, Rajasthan has done some good?
Yes, sir. 2-3 years back, our last XCM.
What are the labour reforms which it has done?
Sir, earlier there was limit that if there are 100 labourers.
Up to 100.
But it has
beyond been. Beyond that, government permission was required. It has been raised to 300. Anything else?
Sir, I cannot recollect.
Okay. You need to study. There are 4 acts in which changes again. Then any other areas of improvement? Bright spots?
Sir, tourism potential.
Good. Tourism has improved, but tourism How do you say tourism has improved? Do you have some figures to say that it is bringing more money or it is bringing more tourists in the state? Do you have some figures?
The recent increase in the figures, I'm not aware, but it's around 4.5 to 6 million of footfall is there. And Rajasthan accounts for around 6% of foreign tourists. In domestic, it's around 2%, but Rajasthan has...
tourism is there. Any other area you can think of? There's improvement in solar and wind.
Solar.
How much solar power is the installed capacity?
So it's around 18 gigawatts.
18 gigawatt?
Total capacity potential is around 142 gigawatts, but we have...
Get your figures right. India total is producing 25.
I think that is plant load factors also.
No. It's producing only 2,300 or 2,400 megawatts. Don't go to gigawatts, we haven't reached that stage yet. What is the growth rate of Rajasthan?
Sir, in 2016-17,
it was
around
7.5%. 7.5, exactly. Alright. You heard of Digital India program?
Yes.
How many panchayats have been connected with optical fiber?
Sir, the BharatNet program was to have connection of around
2.5. How many have been connected?
The progress of the program, I'm not sure.
Progress of it in Rajasthan, can you say? No. How many village panchayats are there in Rajasthan? No idea. How many villages are there in Rajasthan?
I'm not
able to.
How many
districts are there?
It's a 30.
If you were made the collector of Chittorgarh, what's most urgent problems of the people would you like to solve first? Or where you would like to pay attention?
Sir, the basic three communities are not properly availing all the areas of Chittorgarh. Like in our area, the roads were not properly concreted or bitumen.
So you were concentrated on infrastructure, right?
Infrastructure.
Anything else?
Sir, I think there is lack of attention given to the food. Food.
Food.
Which is the major tourist spot.
What else?
The rivers, they are also dry and they are not clean properly. So this is an area.
Okay. You are a civil engineer?
Yes.
What contribution you can make by using local technology, down-to-earth solutions, in combating effects of climate change?
Sir, this concept where we can use fly ash bricks and fly ash and slag in cement.
How many are using it? Go for practical things. Something which is easily you can do.
Sir, we have concept of green buildings. There is concept, but we are not focusing so much.
So you can go for green buildings.
Green buildings.
But anything else?
Green technology, as I said, sir, in the construction sector we can take.
You can go for solar panels, for street lighting, etc.
Yes, sir.
Very simple. Now,
yes,
even in the villagers are using solar panels.
Yes, sir.
And you can go for water harvesting
and
digging water bodies in
yes.
the villages, correct?
Yes.
These are the simple. Alright. Last question. Article 21 of the Constitution. Its scope was changed to due process of law in Menaka Gandhi case.
Yes.
Are you aware of it?
Yes, sir.
So what does the meaning of it, due process of law?
Most of the
questioning will be based on your biodata. There, it is from Rajasthan. Rajasthan is one area. We have asked a number of questions. Second is anthropology. Third is your hobbies like badminton, etc. Fourth is civil engineering.
Yes.
Fifth is you are a second choice for foreign service. These are the main areas of where questions can be asked. So we have asked you accordingly questions, right? And it would be better for you to take a second look at your data and then prepare accordingly.
Okay.
You start your studies from today by answering the questions which we have asked you.
Okay.
Because your answers were not found very adequate. Like Muhammad bin Sultan says, he only said that there is possibility of $100 billion. He never commits. But there are other areas where important things have happened. We have re-strengthened our strategic relationship because we need their oil and gas, number one.
Yes.
Security. Three, in Ratnagiri, we are building a refinery, huge refinery. We are already, Saudi Arabia has committed $11 billion. It's a $44 billion project. So those are some of the areas. Then train 18 also you could explain very nicely. There is a lot of improvements in that train. If you want, you can read it and leave it outside.
Thanks.
For train 18. So, then civil engineering is an important subject. You can be asked what contribution you can make in smart cities, in climate change, etc. Always think local. Don't think of bookish knowledge. What you can do, like I said, you can buy more trees, you can go for more LED bulbs.
Yes, sir.
That kind of thing. More use of natural light, natural breeze for green buildings. Those are the areas. So, in cheese bazaar aap kariye, then constitutional principles are important. Aap se extradition ke baare poocha tha, legal. What is extradition?
Extradition, yes, sir.
I asked you about Mehta Gandhi case.
Yes, sir.
That is not correct. Due process is the process itself, apart from the law. Law must be just and fair. Process must also be just and fair.
Yes, sir.
The emphasis is on process, not on the law.
Yes.
Remember this. Which means it must follow principles of natural justice, the process. फिर ये आपसे इतना पूछा है देखिए फॉरेन सर्विस पे हुआवाई पे पूछा था आपसे हुआवाई पूछा है स्पैनिश इलेक्शन टास्क फोर्स इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग्स एंड एमबीएस ऑफ कोर्स वी आर सी मोहम्मद बिन सुल्तान सो मोर क्वेश्चंस कैन बी देयर व्हाट इज सीपीईसी व्हाट इज बीआरआई व्हाट इज इंडिया डूइंग टू कॉम्बैट चाइनास थ्रेट इन इंडियन ओशन व्हाट इज आवर इंटरेस्ट इन इंडो पैसिफिक रीजन
Yes.
So all those things you have to prepare. Ab aap taiyari kariye sir. Acha. Is tarike se.
Thanks.
Rest is all okay. Your personality, all that is fine. Okay. An important program of the government like Digital India, you don't know anything. And you must know. These are some of the good programs.
Yes, sir.
Ujjwala, Sofagya, Estee. Properly.
Thanks. Good.
आज से पढ़ना शुरू करेंगे
क्या
नहीं बाहर दे देना पढ़ के और चाहो तो वो आपको फोटो कॉपी दे देना
डोंट फॉरगेट टू लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस द बेल आइकन टू नेवर मिस एन अपडेट